An autopsy on a former NFL player who shot and killed six people in April reveals he had an unusually severe form of brain disease. The condition of Phillips Adams was revealed yesterday. Researchers say his football injuries contributed to their diagnosis of stage 2 CTE. The NFL has not responded to their conclusion. Nikki Battiste spoke with the doctor who led that study to find out how the football player's illness may have led him to those killings in South Carolina.
I think there's been a bad shooting.
On April 7th, police say former NFL cornerback Phillips Adams killed prominent physician Robert Leslie, his wife Barbara, two of their grandchildren, and two technicians working at the Leslie's Rock Hill, South Carolina home. Authorities later found Adams with a self-inflicted gunshot wound.
Do you think had Phillips Adams never touched a football, he would have never killed anyone?
Yeah, I do.
Dr. Ann McKee led the examination of Adams' brain after his death. She announced Tuesday that her team found the 32-year-old had extensive CTE at the time of his death. She says it was the severe damage to Adams' frontal lobes that was most surprising.
It's caused by repetitive head impacts to the head. Individuals may have trouble with impulse control, decision making.
Adams was on the field for more than 20 years and suffered two concussions. His family told investigators he had memory issues after his retirement in 2015 and told USA Today his mental health was degrading.
There are, of course, a lot of other people who have had CTE who have not committed murder.
Right. Absolutely. It's unusual. But it has happened before, and given the level of damage, it's hard for me to imagine that it didn't contribute.
Dr. McKee says Adams' extensive disease compares to that of Aaron Hernandez, another former football player who died by suicide in 2017 after being convicted of murder. Her team diagnosed Hernandez with stage 3 CTE after his death.
And we all love sports. That's not enough reason for us to ignore this.
For CBS Mornings, Nikki Battiste.
Before I jump right into CTE, I don't want to be dismissive to the families destroyed by these murders. So our hearts still go out to them. But when it comes to CTE, the NFL, they're trying to do everything that they can. They are pouring money into research and therapy, not just physical, but also mental. Mm-hmm. But there's still a long way to go when it comes to helping athletes deal with it in real time, but more importantly, after they're done playing.
Yeah. I mean, one of the difficult things is you cannot diagnose it until after life.
Until after
so
they
you don't
die.
Know who's really struggling.
Yeah.
I mean,